We would like to thank you all so much for joining us this evening. Dinner and a Show is one of our favorite events in the children's ministry because we love partnering with the Forever Young Ministry so much. It's such a special time for us, and we believe that you all are the best audience in the whole church. These kids have been working so hard on the show, so I don't want to put it off any longer, but I do want to make one quick announcement before we get started. Afterward, if you feel so inclined, we do have to set back up for church in the morning. So if you have a few minutes and can help us move a table or a few chairs, that would be amazing. But enjoy your meal and enjoy the show.
Welcome to Egypt. God's people came here long ago when Joseph was the Pharaoh's second in command, and they never left. The Israelites had many children and grandchildren. In fact, they multiplied so greatly that they became extremely powerful and filled the land. Eventually, a new king came to power in Egypt who knew nothing about Joseph or what he had done. He said to his people, "Look, the people of Israel now outnumber us and are stronger than we are. We must make a plan to keep them from growing even more. If we don't, and if a war breaks out, they will join our enemies and fight against us. Then they will escape from the country." So the Egyptians made the Israelites their slaves. They appointed brutal slave drivers over them, hoping to wear them down with crushing labor. But the more the Egyptians oppressed them, the more the Israelites multiplied and spread, and the more alarmed the Egyptians became. Then Pharaoh gave this order to all his people: "Throw every newborn Hebrew boy into the Nile River, but you may let the girls live."
About this time, a man named Amram and a woman named Jochebed got married. Jochebed became pregnant and gave birth to a son. She saw that he was special and kept him hidden for 3 months. But when she could no longer hide him, she put the baby in a waterproof basket and laid it among the reeds of the bank of the Nile River. The baby's sister then stood at a distance watching to see what would happen to him. Soon Pharaoh's daughter came down to bathe in the river, and her attendants walked along the riverbank. When the princess saw the basket among the reeds, she sent her maid off to get it for her. When the princess opened it, she saw the baby. The little boy was crying. And she felt sorry for him and realized he must be one of the Hebrew children. Then the baby's sister Miriam approached the princess and asked if she could find the Hebrew woman to nurse the baby for her. The princess replied that she should, so Miriam went and called the baby's mother. The princess told Jochebed that she would pay her to nurse the baby, so Jochebed took him back home.
Later, when the boy was older, Jochebed brought him back to the Pharaoh's daughter, who adopted him as his own son. The princess named him Moses, for she lifted him out of the water. Many years later, Moses had to flee Egypt. He became enraged seeing the treatment of his people, and he killed an Egyptian. He ran to Midian and married a Midianite woman. He became a shepherd. One day Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law. He led the flock far into the wilderness and came to Sinai, the mountain of God. There the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a blazing fire from the middle of a bush. Moses stared in amazement. Though the bush was engulfed in flames, it didn't burn up. Moses was amazed and went to investigate. When the Lord saw Moses coming to take a closer look, God called to him from the middle of the bush. "Moses, Moses, do not come any closer. Take off your sandals, for you are standing on holy ground. I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob." When Moses heard this, he covered his face because he was afraid to look at God. Then the Lord told him, "I have certainly seen the oppression of my people in Egypt. I have heard their cries of distress because of their harsh slave drivers." God told Moses that he had chosen Moses to lead his people out of slavery. Moses protested that he was not a good speaker, but God told him he would send his brother Aaron to do the talking. When Moses worried that he wouldn't be believed, God gave him a sign. He told Moses to throw his staff. It became a snake. When he picked it back up, it turned back into a snake. When Moses worried that the people would not know who sent him, God told him, "I am who I am." So Moses set off for Egypt.
Something's wrong with the water.
Let God's people go.
No. We'll be right back.
the Israelites camped on the edge of the wilderness. The Lord went ahead of them. He guided them during the day with a pillar of cloud. And he provided light at night with a pillar of fire. This allowed them to travel by day or night. And the Lord did not remove the pillar of cloud of the pillar of fire in front from its place in front of the people. But God hardened the Egyptians' hearts. They changed their minds and they decided they wanted their slaves back. They charged out to the desert after them. The Israelites were very scared. They said, "It would have been better to stay as slaves in Egypt." God said, "Why are you crying out to me? Moses, tell the people to get moving. Hold out your staff over the Red Sea. Divide the waters so the Israelites can walk through on dry ground." Were so happy they had escaped, they sang and danced and they praised God. Miriam proclaimed,
"Sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. He has hurled both horse and rider into the sea."
Thank you all for joining us this evening. It was an honor to portray the account of God's people and their exodus from Jesus. We hope you enjoyed the show. We'll see you again next year.